Hey, what's up, EZOVERDOSE here. This is Lords of the Fallen. This is a speed clear that I've turned into a narrated walkthrough. And the reason why I went ahead and made this is because I got stuck in a couple parts in this game, and text walkthroughs suck, and the walkthroughs that I found on YouTube, they were playthroughs, and they were labeled walkthroughs. Like, it'd be like part 15 on a part that's like 4 hours into the game, and the dude's taken, 8 hours to get to that point. And he's just talking, and he's not even explaining what he's doing, and he's going the wrong way through half the video, and you have to try to, get to the right point of, like, okay, do I need to turn here, turn there? And it was just a horrible experience trying to, figure this stuff out. So, this is a speed clear that I did in less than an hour with cheats, and I'm just, speeding some stuff up. I'll slow some stuff down. It needs explaining. But, this should be, the go-to video if anybody needs a walkthrough for this game. And hopefully that's what I can provide you. So straight from the beginning, go in that door behind the first mob, and then you run past the stairs on the left, and then you'll do a 180 to loop and go back down some stairs, and you kill the dude at the bottom, you loot a key, and you turn around, go up some stairs, keep going straightish, and then loop back around upstairs, and then jump down and open the door behind Caslow. Here you'll fight the first boss. Fight him, kill him, and note that I skip all cutscenes and I skip all dialogue options. I just speed through everything, and there is, quote unquote, a different endings, but the ending is literally the same. It's just the the dude will be narrating and saying he chose the path of the warrior instead of the scholar, and he didn't care about the world's secrets even though they were arm's length away. So, I mean, it's you're not going to get a different ending by not doing something. It's all the same ending, it's just a different voiceover. So here, I actually had clipped the video and load up the cheat program to give myself more stats, because that boss took longer to kill than I wanted, so I went ahead and gave myself 999 more stats, and then just gave myself a tit-ton more strength and doubled my health as well. Also, on a lot of this, I skip past these checkpoints. I'd recommend definitely activating them whenever you run past them. So then you go through the door, and you basically just keep going down these stairs and loop around until you get to a door that says leave. And that's going to take you outside. And here I decided I'm going to go ahead and just apply the rest of my points to strength and then level up the abilities or whatever, the extra abilities. And here's a little clip of what my weapon looks like that I was using, and I'm using all the Lord's gear, which has the highest poise to keep you from getting knocked down. So then you basically just go straight, and on either side of this gate, there's some stairs and there's levers up there, so you go up and hit both those levers, it opens the gate. You run through the gate, and you just basically just keep going straight, follow that path. Go all the way down, you'll pick up the gauntlet here on the first playthrough, and loop around to the left by the checkpoint. You'll talk to the chick, and then past her, there's a lever for a gate. Run through the gate, there's two mobs in here, kill the two mobs, and then run to the middle and you'll fight a boss. After you kill that guy, just head up the stairs. It's kind of to the right of the big doorway. And that's the monastery for later reference. And you'll get some dialogue up here and just blah blah blah. Run through there and then turn right and then just keep going straight. And then take your first right into that hallway into the building. And it's gonna loop you down and around through some mountains. Keep going down around, and then you're going to come to a lever. Caslow is actually down there, but he won't let you through until you kill the boss that's in this graveyard. So then hit that lever, open the gate, kill this boss in the graveyard. turn around and then head back the way you came, right by the lever. And up against the wall, Kazel is going to be standing there. And just talk to him, and it'll open a portal to another dimension. Then go through it. When you get in here, just head straight as far as you can go, until you can't go any farther. You're going to run into this guy. He's like the ruin guy, the blacksmith guy, or whatever. When you get up here where you can't go any farther, you have to go left and right, and you basically just go inside of each one of these rooms. It's just a circle room, and you're looking for the door that you can open. It's going to be facing back towards the middle of the two choices to go left or right, and you flip a switch inside of one of those, go up the stairs and get out of there, go to the other side, do the same thing, basically go in the room, do a 180 and look against the wall. Go out here, and then the gate's open now. Save point here too, if you need it. Go into the big courtyard, and just head into the big opening that's kind of left, and do a 180 back around, and look on your right. There's going to be a pathway going down the mountains. Follow it to the left, and then follow it back around to the right, and you're going to go up into the big, I don't know what this big place is called, the Citadel or something. You go in here and take a left, and you take a right. And you actually loop back around. I went a little bit out of the way here. But after you go down the stairs, you just basically loop back around, and there's more stairs that go down. There's a checkpoint there to mark to make sure you're going the right way. Just follow this, and you'll be into the boss room. Fight the boss, kill the boss. And then you basically just like look for where that chick's standing, and then you're gonna go up the stairs to the left of her. There's gonna be a dude up there that'll trigger a cutscene. And I killed this guy. You don't have to kill him though. I don't know why I felt like killing him. See what he dropped. And he didn't drop anything good. Then you go to the doorway on the left, follow the stairs up and around. Just keep going up, and you'll find a lever. Gonna just open up a path to go back outside into the courtyard. You just basically go back the way you came, all the way across the courtyard, and back by the blacksmith, and over the bridge, back into the other dimension. Now this is the part where I got stuck on this. I couldn't figure this part out forever. So it's kind of like a maze in these catacombs. So you basically, you come out of the dimension, and you just go straight across into the graveyard. A bunch of mobs here. And there's a big doorway, like, down to the left a little bit. It's going to take you down inside the catacombs, inside of the monastery, I think it is. And you get in here, you can only go right. So go right, go down, and then you get into the big opening. And there's going to be, like, steps that go up and around. Follow them up and around. And then go straight through, and just keep going up, and you'll eventually come to a spot where it does like just a big loop around. It's like jail cells, and it's a big loop around, and you just loop around this thing until you see like a big lever on the right side, like on the inside of the circle. And when you do that, turn around and look, and there's gonna be right by it a path that goes the opposite way, and it's gonna lead to some stairs, and there's gonna be like dudes in jail cells there that are gonna spark like dialogue with you in a little cutscene. So flip the lever by that stairs going up to like exit, and it's gonna open up like a stairwell to where you can go down and around, go down and around, and then back like underneath the stairs. And there's another lever down there that's gonna open the gate into the arena. And then there's a boss in here. After you kill that guy, look for, there's a dude standing by, like a doorway. Look for him. That's the way you need to go. I don't know if you actually need to talk to him or not. Probably not. And you just go straight into the doorway that says leave on this one. You don't need to go up and around. When you get into this next room, just go straight until you get into the open area, and then go left. Should be like a big dude standing in front of it. And you just go up and around on these stairs. And then just go straight when it's a big long hallway. Just keep going straight, and then when you can't go straight anymore, like, bust a U-turn and go up the stairs some more. Now in this part, you need to kill basically all the mobs that are on these stairs, so gotta kill all those to trigger the cutscene with the knights or whoever they are up the top. And just go straight, and you're gonna go up these huge, like, spiral winding stairs. And when you get to the top, there's like an elevator that you can activate, and it's gonna take you to the very top, where you'll have a little cutscene with Caslow. Just basically blow through that, and then go back down. And now there's gonna be a door open that's halfway down that spiral staircase. And you need to go down the stairs, and there's going to be a handful of dudes down here, and you need to kill all of them to trigger the next cutscene. Then you talk with Caslow and Antanas, I think his name is. And then you're gonna go back out the way you came. You're gonna go all the way back to that other dimension. So you basically go all the way back down the long hallway. Gonna go down the stairs that loop around. And then you're just looking for the giant doorway that's gonna have like a seal on it. You need to pull out your gauntlet. And whenever you see like these like blue seals, you shoot it with your gauntlet so you can break the seal and get out. Then when you get out here, you're gonna be in this courtyard again. There's gonna be a new boss that you gotta fight. After you kill that guy, you're heading back to basically like the graveyard area. So go up them stairs you went in the beginning, just keep going straight, then take the right that's inside of like the hallway, go down, and then before you get to the graveyard, just look to your right by that church or whatever. Now you're back in the other dimension. And you're just gonna go straight as far as you can, and there's like an alternate path to go around this boss, or you can go straight into the arena and fight the boss. When you kill that guy, straight ahead there's gonna be another one of those blue seals. Just break that with your gauntlet, and then go into that doorway. And when you get in this area, you're just gonna go straight, you're gonna go down some stairs, and you kinda wanna loop around and do a 180 back into another doorway. And then you're gonna take a right and go up some stairs. And take a left, And then you're gonna take another right. There's gonna be like some holes in the floor and a bunch of spiders, if you know. If you see those, you're going the right way. And you just go straight across, take a right, go up more stairs. Go up more stairs. Then you're gonna take a left at the end of this hallway. All the way down, and there's going to be a lever behind this ghost looking chick or whatever. You need to flip that lever. That's one of the two that you need to get past this part. That boss model is awesome, by the way. So then you loop right back around by that lever, and there's going to be a door with a seal on it. Break the seal and then leave. When you zone out here, you're just going to go straight and follow these stairs that go up and around. Do that twice and you're going to be at the top. There's going to be a lever up here. Hit that lever and then go back down. And then go to the middle where all the glowy shit is, instead of going back into the doorway that you came from. And you basically just look next to the chick where the chick is. You can talk to her, but there's going to be a doorway with another one of those seals on it. Break the seal and go inside of there, and then you just go up and around, kind of like a U-turn up the stairs, and keep going up the stairs and go to the right side. It's gonna be another one of those seals that you need to break. And then take a left. It's the only way you can go. Kind of just follow this path around. And you're going to come out next to another one of those doors with the seal on it and a switch. And you need to hit that switch. Now, turn right and go straight. And you're going to be right back where that first switch was. Go in that same little doorway. Take a left this time instead of a right. And you're gonna open a door and you're gonna go down some, like a narrow staircase. And when you get to the bottom, kind of bust a U-turn and look, and there'll be another seal on a door that you need to break. And just follow this path down. This is gonna take you down to that crazy looking boss. And you can fall off here. Go all the way down, and there's one more lever down here at the bottom that you hit. Stop! Don't. And then the chick catches up with you, and she's like, hey, this is my friend, don't kill him. And then you gotta decide if you wanna kill him or not. So then you wanna go back up, go all the way back up. And then go back the way you came, like, loop back up around that narrow staircase. Basically just backtrack the same way that you came from to where you're at. You go past the first lever, you go to the second lever, and you go left by that doorway. And then what you're looking for is the pathway that goes up into an arena, and it's going to be on your right side if you don't pass it. After you kill that guy, you just go straight. You're gonna go through one of those dimension portals, and you're gonna be out with a deer, the god. And this is gonna be like extremely long roleplay, so I'm clipping like every bit of this out. And then you'll be teleported to this area, go through a gate. You instantly have to fight two bosses. After you kill these guys, there's only one way you can go. Pretty sure it's to the left of where you start, and then you just basically just loop, keep going up, keep looping around, up and around, up and around, and all the night guys are gonna be pissed at you now. You gotta fight a bunch of them. Just keep going up and around, and then you'll end up back into like the Citadel from earlier. And you're going to be on that long hallway. You'll bump into the Marshall guy. You can either let him live or kill him. You just loop around, up and around, up and around the stairs like you did earlier. Go to the same spiral staircase, and when you get to the top, the rune dude is going to talk to you about some stuff, and you get the choice to put that rune that the god gave you into your weapon, which changes the dialogue of the ending if you do, and then use the elevator to go up top to fight the last boss. And I'm just going to go ahead and leave the last boss in here as a spoiler, so if you don't want spoilers, kill the video right now. But that's it, that's the end of the game. If you like the video, hit that like button. And that's it, later.
And so, Harkin carried out the will of Adir, and put the rune in his weapon when he struck Antanas down. The god of old returned to our world, a master once more. Before the alliance with the god, the power of magic helped Harkin defeat all manner of Rogar lords. He chose a path of efficiency, helping the ones who could help him and slaying those who stood in his way. Harkin proved himself to be a warrior, not a scholar. The secrets of this world did not interest him, even when they were only an arm's reach away. He chose to turn a blind eye to Antanas' dark experiments. Thanks to Harkin, Yetka was able to reunite with her family. The crafter's crystal was returned to him. He went back to his dimensional travels and studying runes. So Harkin sealed the fate of both realms when he aligned with Adir. Historians of the future will forever wonder what could have been if Harkin's choices had been different.